In the aftermath of World War II, the world found itself divided, not by the battle lines, but by the profound ideological rift. On one side, the United States championed freedom, democracy, and capitalism. On the other hand, the Soviet Union sought to spread communism and control under the iron fist of its regime. This division set the stage for a conflict that will shape the second half of the 20th century, a conflict fought not with bombs and bullets, but with espionage, propaganda, and constant threat of annihilation. This is the story of the Cold War. As Europe lay in ruins after the World War II, the Allies were faced with the daunting task of rebuilding. But as they did, a new rivalry emerged. In the East, the Soviet Union, led by Joseph Stalin, sought to expand its influence, creating a buffer zone of communist states in Eastern Europe. To the West, the United States, under President Harry Truman, introduced the Marshall Plan, a massive aid program to rebuild Western Europe and prevent the spread of communism. Tensions mounted as Soviets tightened their grip on Eastern Europe. In response, the West formed NATO, a military alliance to counter the Soviet aggression. The world was split into two: communism versus capitalism, East versus the West, and in the middle of it all was Berlin, a city divided not just by ideology, but by a wall. The 1960s brought the Cold War to its most dangerous point: the Cuban Missile Crisis. The world watched in horror as the United States and the Soviet Union came into a brink of nuclear war. President John F. Kennedy faced off against Soviet Premier Nikita Khrushchev, each man knowing that one wrong move could spell the end of humanity. For 13 days, in October 1962, the world held its breath, but diplomacy, back-channel negotiations, and sheer willpower averted disaster. The missiles were withdrawn, but the Cold War was far from over. It will continue to shape every aspect of life, politics, culture, and even sports. While the threat of nuclear war loomed large, much of the Cold War was fought in the shadows. Espionage became the name of the game, with the CIA and KGB locked in a deadly dance of deception. From the streets of Berlin to the jungles of Vietnam, spies gathered secrets, planted disinformation, and orchestrated coups. But it wasn't just on the ground. The space race became another front in this battle for supremacy. The Soviet Union struck first with Sputnik in the Yuri Gagarin, the first man in the space. The United States responded with Apollo program, culminating in Neil Armstrong's historic moon landing in 1969. The Cold War reached for the stars, even as it cast a long shadow on Earth. The 1980s saw the Cold War begin to thaw. Economic pressures, internal dissent, and the leadership of Mikhail Gorbachev led to reforms in the Soviet Union. But it was in Berlin, the symbol of Cold War, where the world would witness its end. On November 1989, the Berlin Wall fell, marking the beginning of the end of the Soviet Union. The Cold War, which had gripped the world in fear for nearly half a century, was over. The Iron Curtain was lifted and the world entered a new era. The Cold War was a conflict unlike any other, fought in the shadows, waged with ideas as much as with weapons. It shaped the world, leaving behind a legacy of caution and hope, a reminder of how close we came to destruction, and how we ultimately chose peace. The echoes of the Cold War still linger, but they remind us of the resilience of humanity in the face of unimaginable tensions. This narrative and this story can be adapted, and we can see how the Cold War affected the world, but it led to a lot of inventions such as the moon landing. Some people claim that it was a hoax because now there is a lot of technology, but no one has ever gone back to the moon. So guys, you can subscribe to this channel if you are new here, and let us know in the comments below what you think about this video. Thank you so much.